Mislim da nije zločin biti drugačiji od ostalih. Trebaš prihvatiti sebe i ići dalje. Ja mislim da je to tako. Ja opet kažem, vama svaka čast. Ja sam mislila da sam jedina osoba koja će otprilike biti hrabra. Vi ste hrabri na kubik.
As you know, probably the situation in Serbia isn't better than the film we saw here also. So in one point, Brave Gods and her three friends decided to come up publicly, and they asked for help for one NGO in Belgrade, which called us artists to help them to meet theater performance that you saw in the film. And I started first with four of them, then I got lost, so I decided that I should just make a film about one character, which was Gotsam, and I think through the film you probably all realize why. And it was almost 2 years with some breaks that we shot and edited the film. Gotsam was collaborator from the beginning because we wanted to tell hundreds of the percent of the truth of her life and the story.
Thank you. Just not to leave out Ivana and Gotsam because they've traveled from Belgrade and they came to show their film. I wanted to ask, do you have the same type of viewers? Are you able to show the film in Belgrade? And, okay, of course, Belgrade is quite more progressive than other parts of Serbia, but can you get your message across in other parts of Serbia? Novi Sad, of course. What about the South?
Although we were very frightened, I mean, Gotsam was the brave one. I was even not sure shall we do it or not, because I was afraid the screening will, somebody will, like nationalists will come and stop the screening and everything. But it was great because it was like a film festival, and I think that nationalists are not so interested in it because we had it and we even got the award, so it was really great. In Sarajevo was beautiful also, and regarding all the other parts of the Serbia, we will see, because we still have this issue of being afraid of the people who are having their identities in the films, like how everybody else will, you know, like if somebody recognized someone or something like that. I mean, what is the brave one, but and what is very weird that it was a nationalist that at the end we had problems with. It was some gay communities that we had problems within Serbia, so again, it's a Balkan issue or whatever.
Hiç nuk mai ment, duna me pyt në alën tëmë.
Që i kanë kalu me vetë vetën, me familjen e ngusht, me rejtën e ngusht dhe me tërë shëqëri.
Ne s'kemi mujtë mi fotografu ata persona, kështu që këtë koncepti edhe është lidh me...
Vesh ata ju në konë të e shkateru.
I nisha kolegët e mi të bërtit, edhe veç këmë djerë krytën pak në koridore dhe këmë pa që ka qenë të ndodhë.
Dhe atë ku ka qenë 52 kolegës.
Vesa, when did you decide to do a film? Was it right then, after?
We found ourselves in a very interesting position following like everything that happened with the sex issue, and a lot was expected from us as well, like to continue the talk. And we felt that we wanted to do something more, and at the same time, I mean, there's a lot of appreciation and people just, there was people glorifying us and there was people hating us. So we wanted to kind of talk about all of that was happening. And at the same time, we had just so much footage of getting ready. It was like, as at this, as in the movies, like 8 of us for 3 days in a row, setting things up, you know, physical work. And we had all that passion and that work that we put into the magazine, recorded, and we just didn't want like that experience to die out.
My question is, did you expect these threats when you were setting out to bring out this magazine? Were you aware, or has something like this happened before, or was it just sudden?
They do continue to remain a smaller group within our society, but that are trying to get more vocal and that are trying to have more of a political power in Kosovo. So that's a threat that we see right now, and for us it was very important. Why we did the movie also was that if we don't talk about these right now, then like after 10 years it might actually be too late. Maybe we were a bit naive as well, you know, thinking that they're not going to mobilize, but they did, and they did it really fast. Like, they did it in 2 days, because 2 days prior to the launch of the magazine is when they actually found out that we were going to be publishing a magazine on those topics. So it was really scary just how fast they could mobilize. And I mean, it's just we have to talk about it right now, because if you don't, I don't want it to be too late. We live in a country where 70% of the population is very young, and we have to think about that and how we can use that to develop the place. So these are like just some of the things that we in general are trying to do.
Yeah.
So it's not just a magazine that talks just about the LGBT community, and for us that was also important, because first, we want to put all kinds of stories in one place. We're not going to separate and say, like, this is an issue that talks only about LGBT, because we don't want to separate it as such. We want to talk about it as part of one society. So, but because of the fact that it was the first time that somebody talked about, like, gay rights, like, in that kind of an outspoken way, it got hugely interpreted as a magazine talking only about gay rights and nothing else. And the thing with the cover that we talk about in the movie, you know, like the people with the covered faces, it's not only, it doesn't pertain only to LGBT, it's about all, like, our entire society. Like, what kind of society are we building? Is it one where everybody's entitled to their own opinion and they can also participate freely in the public sphere or not, you know? So it's much, you know, it's talking about all these issues. Mm-hmm.